we'll have to leave it at that because we have some more breaking news coming in. Well, it's now official. Hockey coach Van Aas will not return. India Today was the first to report that the Hockey India 9-member executive committee, which met today, will make this sacking official. As reported by India Today, the hockey coach is being replaced. We have Shivani now joining us live from the newsroom. Shivani, just take us through the details of the replacement.
That's right, Vedika. We were the first to report when the matter came to light last week or early this week that despite the fact that Hockey India denied sacking him on 13 July, that actually the controversy that ensued put paid on Paul Van Aas returning ever as the India coach. And that decision has now been confirmed. We were also the first to report that Roland Olsman, who's the high performance director, will be made in charge of the team till Rio Olympics. And that decision is also confirmed by the hockey committee that met today. That meeting finished just a short while ago. The other big decision that is to come from this committee meet is the suspension of Gurbaaz Singh, the Indian player who was part of the 2012 London Olympics, 2010 World Cup and so on. He was reported for indiscipline and anti-team activities, and that decision has also been officially made in this hockey committee meet. Of course, while this decision was expected, especially on the future of Paul Van Aas, it does raise a question of how things are working in Hockey India, because he's become the fourth international coach, foreign coach, to actually leave on acrimonious terms. The one before him, Terry Walsh, left after a very public spat with Hockey India's boss, Narendra Batra, and this man too has had a spat with Narendra Batra, although he claims that actually it was Paul Van Aas who was rude to him. But the entire matter definitely hurting the Indian team. Another coach will leave, although it is a continuation of Roland Olsman who will take charge, but this definitely is not good news just 12 months before the next Olympics, and that is the big worry when it comes to Indian hockey.
The big worry also being the morale of the team, Shivani, as we speak, because you yourself have just mentioned how there's been this quick change in coaches within the Hockey India team, and this could have a severe psychological effect on our players ahead of the Olympic Games in Rio next year.
Absolutely, it's never a good thing if you keep losing coaches. You know, you had Michael Knobbs, he was fired for low performance. Then you had Terry Walsh, and the team was liking working under him, and he was producing results. Remember, it was under Terry Walsh that India actually became the first team to qualify for the Olympics by winning the Asian Games gold. But then, you know, another coach, this one, Paul Van Aas, has actually had a tenure of just 6 months. So that is not the kind of stability you want.
Yes.
But Hockey India is firm that it was actually Paul Van Aas who crossed a line, and therefore there is no chance of him returning. Harbinder Singh, a former Olympian, was actually head of this committee, and he has confirmed that decision now. Of course, all eyes on Hockey India on how they manage the fallout of this, and Roland Olsman, who will be the man in charge to take the team as close to a podium finish as possible in the 2016 Rio Olympics.
All right, thank